This is a car, and this is a West Coast Customs car.
Yeah, tattoos and tailpipes, I'm bad to the bone.
What started out as a one-man shop has grown into a worldwide empire.
We're the West Coast Wizards of leather and chrome.
No matter how big we get, it's still all about the car.
Creative innovative is the name of the game.
At West Coast Customs, we build the cars that people always dream about.
West Coast Customs, gonna build it your way.
I'm Ryan Friedman House,
and I'm inviting you inside West Coast Customs. West Coast Customs and General Motors have had a long-standing relationship. In the past, we've done builds for celebrities with them. They've given us cars for other builds that we've been working on. And recently, they've hooked us up with American Cancer Society. When this car is finished, it's gonna go to the Cattle Baron's Ball in Detroit, and all the money that we raise is gonna go to help out the American Cancer Society. A couple representatives from American Cancer Society are coming by today to really go over some design ideas. I went out and borrowed a white convertible Camaro to walk around the car, get their opinion on what they think we should do, and kind of give them some of my ideas. Hi, guys.
Hey, Ryan.
Hi. Hi,
Ryan.
Thank you for coming out here. Before we go and talk about design or anything on the car, I would love to show you guys my shop and show you kind of what we do here.
The Road to Recovery program is part of a transportation effort. Unfortunately, patients sometimes make a choice as to what kind of treatment they can take because they don't have a ride to treatment. This will really help us ensure that people don't have to make that decision.
So when you guys pulled up, did you see that white Camaro we had out front?
Yeah, we did.
So that's what we're gonna start with. You wanna go outside and look at it, and
yeah,
I can
kind of
explain why I chose that car? Okay, let's do it. Camaro, for me, I figured it was the best car to start with because it is about the rebirth of Detroit and the rebirth of this car, you know, the whole Camaro coming back. And it's already a great car.
It's already a great car.
We gotta do is just add our West Coast flavor to it and, you know, your guys' influence.
I think it's all about speed and strength and performance, you know?
Right.
These are kind of the elements when we think about the cancer journey.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what this car represents, that's what we need, right?
I've been a Road to Recovery driver since 2003. It's totally volunteer. I use my car, I pick up a patient where they live and drive them to their treatment. It's really incredible to know that the amount of effort being put into this vehicle for the American Cancer Society is going to make such a difference. I'm sure this car is going to be absolutely spectacular when it comes out of the shop here.
One of my ideas I had that I wanted to talk to you guys about is maybe doing like the American flag down the side.
That's a good idea.
I mean, I want to do it kind of ghosted where it looks like it's behind the paint a little bit. And then I want to do the logo on the hood and whatever else, you know, you guys think might be cool. I mean, I'm going to put cool wheels on them and do a body can. I'm going to do the West Coast Customs thing that we do.
How about entertainment? Do you need a little entertainment value when you're driving patients back and forth to treatment?
That would be a big hill.
Yeah.
The American Cancer Society desperately needs drivers to take people to their treatments. I think we'll draw attention to the need for transportation, and as a tie-in with our Road to Recovery, obviously, I wouldn't mind having a car like that and taking patients to their treatment.
So I think I got some good ideas. I mean, the next step will be getting the car in the shop, getting the design figured out, and getting building on it.
When can I drive it?
Soon.
I'm really excited about the design that Ryan has been inspired to do. To me, this vehicle really represents not only the journey that a cancer patient takes, but it also is a vehicle to raise more funds. Through those funds, we can continue to help patients and really get them on the road to recovery.
I am a two-time cancer survivor. When I was diagnosed, my world just shattered. I just didn't know what to do. I just can't say enough about American Cancer Society because they was there when I needed help. With West Coast providing this car to ACS, it's just tremendous. Words just cannot express how thankful we are for West Coast doing this for us.
This build really hits home for me. I mean, recently we lost Megan's father from cancer. A couple months before that, I lost my grandmother from cancer. So cancer is one of those things that, you know, it's in our family, and It's really a horrible thing to watch your family member go through it and then actually lose them. I'm going to put a lot of effort into this. It's to raise money for a great organization to help people. I'm happy that GM called me and asked to be a part of this. And, you know, the next step is to build an awesome car. So I just had a meeting with American Cancer People. I think I got a lot of ideas. Now I need to sit down with Jeff, put those ideas on the paper, and get it approved. GM's called us. They asked us to work with American Cancer Society. I said, for sure, we'd love to do something with them. And obviously with Garnet losing from cancer and my grandmother, it's like a kind of one that touches home a little bit. Basically, they want to build a Camaro and they want to auction it off at one of their auctions in Detroit. I've been trying to figure out what would look the best with, you know, trying to represent American Cancer Society and represent GM the way they want to be represented and come up with a cool car that somebody's going to bid a lot of money on. Their logo is pretty basic. It's red, white, and blue, which is cool. So it's American themed colors.
Yeah, okay.
I think we should do maybe American themed paint job.
The colors, red, white, and blue, we can, you know, do something cool with that. You know, make the car mostly white with some red and blue accents or something.
Yeah, I'm gonna leave it in your hands. We'll do, you know, nice body kit, wheels, you know, the basic stuff like we always do, but it's gotta scream American.
Okay, I can do it.
All right. Handle it.
You're talking to the right guy.
Am I talking to Jeff?
Yes, yeah.
Sir. Oh, okay.
You're talking to Jam Master Jeff.
Jam Master Jeff. For a rolling tribute to the American Cancer Society, we'll start off with a 2011 convertible Camaro, straight off the showroom floor. Once this car is broken down, it's off the paint for a coat of pearl over the factory white. Next step is to get Rhino, our painter, to work, spraying out the ghosted American flag. Under the hood, SLP will hook us up, brand new supercharger, headers, and exhaust system. Then there's the updated suspension and brakes. And finally, a subframe connector to make this whole thing feel like riding on rails. The interior will get a full West Coast treatment, with all new red leather and embroidered ACS logos in the seats. The stock stereo is coming out and gets replaced with a top-of-line Pioneer connected to a custom subbox in the trunk. This Camaro will be riding on a brand new set of Continental tires wrapped around three-piece HRE wheels painted to match the exterior. In the end, this will be one incredible Camaro for a cause. Again, GM came through, but this time, it's a Camaro for a cause. All right, Kenny.
What we got?
Here's another one. We need to go upstairs and go over a plan.
All right, let's go.
All right, guys. Here we go. American Cancer Society. Cancer is a big problem. I'm sure everybody in some way have had to deal with it. So we want to really put a lot into this. This one means a lot. You know, this car is going to be auctioned off to raise money for the American Cancer Society.
Cool.
So GM's hooking us up with a brand new Camaro. Interior-ish. I think we do red, white, and blue theme somehow. Do their logo maybe in the seat. The paint right now, I mean, I told Jeff to do the American flag ghosted on it. I mean, I know we're gonna have a challenge with the ghosting because of the colors and how the colors change when you fade them out.
The red over white, we might have to, we'll play with it a little bit.
So you're gonna have to play with this one, it'll be kind of tricky. I had Jeff put their logo on the hood, the sword.
Right.
It's a little ghosted on there, but I don't know if I'm 100% sold on it. So I think we do it and we'll look at it together and see if that makes sense. Whatever we can do to add value to it. Yeah, so when they auction it off, it's like a one-of-one car. I think we know what we need to do. I guess the first thing is break it down.
We need to keep the whole car together because we're doing graphics. The graphics have to flow through all the panels. So we take all the panels off, we gotta put them back on to do all the graphic work. The most important part of the build right now is gonna be the graphics. We gotta make it easier for the painter so we get this project done.
West Coast Customs-ish.
What's up?
You have to say no to cancer. First, you start with cigarettes.
So Mike from Streetson is coming through with another body kit.
So I'm honored to be a part of this build. This car should represent the American Cancer Society with the American feel. Since it is a GM car, it is made in America. I want to do something where we put the American flag into it, we put their logo, which is red, white, and blue, into it, and just really make a cool car that they can put up at auction and raise a bunch of money for this foundation. Since we are trying to raise money, we want to put everything we can under the hood and really make this car perform. So SLP gave us a supercharger, the brakes, the suspension, the exhaust, the headers. I mean, they gave us their full package, 680 horsepower, 600 pounds of torque. I mean, it's going to be unbelievably fast.
SLP really came through with a really high-performance hood. Instead of being able to only be able to take the car and put graphics on it now we got to go ahead and blend all the color into it. So we got to repaint the hood, repaint the lower fascias, put a new rocker on it. Since we're changing all the components on it, we're going to have to base coat a lot of stuff, and then we can go lay graphics on top. At the end, it's going to take a little bit longer, but it's got the West Coast flavor.
Ish.
What's up?
I need to tell you something about cancer. Okay? You have to say no to cancer. First, you start with cigarettes.
Don't smoke,
no lung cancer.
Never smoke my life.
All right, so talk to me about these seats. How are these seats gonna look? Oh, we got a sample?
It can be a seat cover or it can be an apron.
I like
however, however you wanna wear it.
I want you to wear that while you're making the seats. Could you do that?
This is the sample.
This is gonna be all embroidered, like?
Yeah, white.
So what are you gonna do on the headrest?
I was thinking about the American flag.
The American flag?
Yeah.
I think it's too much.
Think so?
Yeah, because the whole car is gonna have the American flag going down the side.
You call the cap.
I mean, honestly, the shot would be do it all black. I think you leave the top with nothing, since we're gonna have this huge logo down the center. Do what you do-ish. Do-ish.
Do it.
Hey, I'm coming up with that. Do-ish.
So now those are done with the body strip down, we're actually going to get on a lift and go ahead and do the suspension repair. We're going to replace the sway bars, suspension, the shocks, the springs, the body mounts, and get this thing ready for paint. SLP really came through. They gave us the whole entire performance upgrade kit, some coilover shocks, sway bars, and some new brakes. So with the new shocks and everything, the performance is going to be a lot better, the handling is going to be a lot better, and the braking system is going to be a whole lot better. These are our new 6-piston Brembo calipers that SLP supplied us for this build. Because we're going 780 horsepower in the build, we need something more substantial to hold the top of this car. So the good thing about the system is it's actually really easy to put on. Anybody can do it at home. The kit you just buy and a bolt-on kit.
So today we're working on a Camaro for American Cancer Society. The nice thing about that, it's going to be auctioned off and all the proceeds are going to go to American Cancer Society. On this car, we're going to do something a little bit nice, make it sound good. We're going to do 310s in the trunk. Being that the trunk is so small, so tight, we got to do 3 separate boxes. Right now, what I'm going to do is just start cutting up some wood, mocking it up, and see how it fits, and get it to work. All right, we got one of these done. Got 2 more to make. If you're wondering why there's a big hole in the side of my box, because it's 3 separate boxes, they all come together. Not one whole box won't fit in the trunk.
So Mike from Streets Inc. again is coming through with another body kit.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Long time no see, man.
Yeah, how you been?
Hasn't been long since the last Camaro, huh?
Yeah. All right, I got our newest chin spoiler. We always do carbon fiber or hard urethane for you. I wanted to do something different this time for this kit. So this is our new Generation 3 chin spoiler.
Very nice, nice quality.
Yep, and it should take the hits pretty good.
So what do we got? We got rockers, grill.
I got a grill for you. I got a side skirt kit.
Everything's urethane, huh?
Yeah, everything's urethane.
That'd be nice.
So four-piece.
Like OEM manufactured parts, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. So four-piece, these just came out too, so we had an even box for you.
Very cool.
Four-piece.
We've got everything. Let's get it inside.
Yeah, let's go. Cool.
Coming up next on Inside West Coast Customs. I met Will recently. He's one of those artists that really doesn't understand how talented he really is. Wow.
We're gonna start laying out some American flag, get this thing started.
So in the beginning of this build, I let the guys know, you know, this car is for American Cancer Society. We're gonna raise money to help the foundation. Everyone in the shop has had to deal with cancer in one way or another. This means a lot to everybody. I want my guys to do what they do best and, you know, put in 100% and make this car awesome.
On this build, SLP hooked us up with everything. We got the brakes, we got the suspension, we got the headers, we got the supercharger. Anything performance, they're the place we go. Yeah, not only SMP sent us some nice suspension parts, he also gives some subframe connectors. Subframe connectors basically stiffen up the body, so when we put 780 horsepower under this thing, the body can handle the power. As the horsepower comes from the motor to the back of the wheels, it really gives the body more of a stiffer appearance. So when you take off, it doesn't really flex on you, it can take off as a straighter line. With the subframe connectors in here, this thing's really gonna ride like it's on rails. SLP gave us another set of headers. Not that they only look good, they're gonna add some horsepower.
I met Will recently. I mean, he's one of those artists that really doesn't understand how talented he really is. He came in here, he brought me a gift. He had a Shaq jersey painted up since he knew Shaq was one of the biggest pieces of the success of West Coast Customs. I said, you know what, man? It would be awesome if you could do something for my grandfather, you know, since obviously he was the biggest reason why I'm here and what I'm doing. I gave him the jacket that he wore all the time in a picture, actually not even a good picture, and he created this, which was awesome. Recently, we lost Garnet, Megan's father, which was another big piece of my life. And, you know, I told him, hey, Will, I got another job for you. Can you do this shirt that Garnet used to wear? Was something that the guys are always gonna remember him by, because he was always the grumpy one, flipping everybody off, you know, kind of giving him a hard time. This guy blows me away every single time.
Here it is, finally.
Wow. Dude, that's crazy. I can't believe, I swear to God, every single one is better and better and better, Will. I knew this one would be tough for you. Garnet had a lot of wrinkles in his face.
You know what, I kind of feel bad that the two times I've been on the show is to bring you a piece of a loved one that, you know, passed away.
Megan will really, really, really appreciate this.
Yeah, so hopefully this will be the last one that goes in here. I've been painting my whole life, ever since I could remember. But seriously, you know, doing it full time about 12 years now.
This is cool though, man.
Ryan, he's been supportive from the beginning. I can definitely see in his face every time I bring one that he enjoys it, and you know, that makes it all worth it.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, brother.
Thank you very much, brother.
Appreciate it.
You did it again, Will. The Camaro's in the booth, it's prepped. They're about to lay down the pearl so Rhino can get in the booth and really do his magic on the car. All the graphics on this car are gonna be really ghosted. They're gonna be done in pearls. We're gonna do the American flag down the side, and we're also gonna do the American Cancer logo on the hood. I wanna do them in pearls just because I don't want it to be too loud, but I also want it to get its statement out.
We've got the car masked up, everything's ready to go. Now it's the time to do samples. Being a little bar mat shoddy right now. We are going from the light color to dark. As you can see, this is pearl with no color to it, which gets me to the first shade right there. When you add a candy concentrate to it, ooh, So now we're gonna get the red and white stripes out of it, and I just gotta make sure I get the right thing on this before I screw it up in there. We'll let that dry, pull it off, see what it looks like. I don't like the blue though. That's what experimenting's all about.
So I just checked in with Rhino, went over a couple different ways he had the pearl, he added some candy to it. I'm not happy with it right now. He's gonna have to come up with another technique to do this, because in the rendering and the idea that I have in my head, I really want this thing to be ghosted. I don't want it to stand out where bam, it's a big American flag. But when you get up to it or when the light hits it, I want you to see the blue, I want you to see the red, I want you to see the stars. So we're gonna have to come up with something in between what he's got right now. So hopefully he'll have a couple more spray outs for me in the next hour. I can improve him, he can get in the booth and start spraying the car.
All right, we got the American Cancer Camaro in the booth. We're gonna start laying out some American flag, get this thing started. We got the ice white pearl on it. Now it's actually blinging like we should. That's gonna be my base for my white stars. So doing ghost patterns, you wanna use the vinyl tape because you'll have a perfect edge. And what I'm gonna do is come off of the light here and follow my body lines going through it. So up and over the fender, up and over the door handle, up and over here, and then out the back. For this particular American flag, it's gonna be subtle, but the Ice Pro that we're gonna put on is make this thing jump in the sun, and it'll still make it look badass. About 8 hours of taping, 1 hour of spraying. I have vinyl stenciled some stars here. Pre-cut, saved me a lot of time. I've angled them to go back towards the car. Instead of it having a boring star, I thought it wouldn't look cool, so what I did is I made it look like it's moving because the car is hauling ass. I'll give a thumb space here and a thumb space here, and we'll set the first star. Bam! And now, welcome to the magic of television. Starting, ending. Just like that, magic before your eyes. The only thing left to do is put that American Cancer Society logo right here on the hood scoop, mask it off.
We're ready to spray.
That's it, look at that, three and three. I've learned the hard way many, 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 and many more times of what not to do.
Wow.
Follow me, hoes. Okay, that's the rev. Wait for this to dry. Move on to the blue pearl.
Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
Both fades are done. Blue and red's done. It's time to unveil the flag.
So the paint on this has got to be special. When me and Jeff sat down and went over the design of it, I definitely didn't want it to be a humongous American flag down the side. So I said, look, if we're going to do the American flag theme, let's do it where it's ghosted. So we'll do it in some pearls so it looks like the American flag's underneath the paint. We're gonna keep the interior simple, stay with the red, white, and blue theme, do the American Cancer Society insignia on the seats, and just keep it simple.
All right. Just gonna load up here my blue. Wow, that's amazing. It's nothing like the blue flag, but I'll make it look like it. We got the red stripes done, moving on to the blue. We kind of veered from the path of the original drawing. They had it ghosted. Mine's a ghost and fade. Kind of the same, but different. Come on, I'll show you. So we're doing the same thing that we did with the stripes. It's darker if it fades to light. Do the same thing with the flag meets real in the middle. It'll be darker here. Fade light in the front. Going around the front side. These white stars will pop out perfect.
Now that the seat cover is ready, I'm gonna put them back on the seat. Let's see how it's gonna look. See this sword? It's got a big meaning. It's the sword of the doctors use to defeat cancer. Cancer, no good. It's not welcome. This is a Herbeck. It's a lifesaver. Herbeck. It's very important to remember how to put whatever you break apart, very important to remember how to put it back together. Face. When you put the simmer on the leather, it makes it like so soft that you can mold it in like really good. Once I put the seat cover on the frame, and all I gotta do after, steam it up a little bit to get rid of all the wrinkles, all the little things that I don't like, make it look tight. But you know, I got magic on my hands. I can make those wrinkles disappear.
Okay, both fades are done. Blue and red's done. It's time to unveil the flag. It fades off into the white car. To the existing base coat. Sweet. That's a ghosted flag. More to pull off and we'll be ready to clear it.
American Cancer Society Camaro is already cleared and finished. Now it's time to roll it out and get it assembled.
This trunk is very small. One whole box, one chamber. It won't fit as one box, so we gotta kind of break it apart and have a puzzle we gotta put together. There you go. We got three subwoofers that are gonna go in here. Essentially, Diamond Audio D3s. Haven't worked that out yet, but we're gonna make it fit.
I have a port that's coming into the cab. Pretty much gonna fill the cab with the base. This little thingamajig just happened to be in my way. So we went ahead and cut it out, and now we have room to
so that instead of having all your bass trapped in your trunk, actually lets it breathe into the cab and makes it sound a whole lot better.
So what do we got here today?
Well, we've got an SLP TVS 2300 supercharger. This is one of our unique red casings here. It's a positive displacement 2300cc supercharger, and it adds roughly 150 horsepower to the motor with 6 pounds of boost. But with this package, we've added a pulley, and total output for this package will be 630 horsepower.
So 630?
Yes.
Wow, that's good.
Absolutely. It's a self-contained unit. Everything we produce for the vehicle, including the supercharger, the intercooler, and all the accessories, it's all self-contained.
And it's a really nice-looking unit, clean, sharp, very state-of-the-art. Well, here comes the fun part. I think Tommy is ready for this nice unit.
Yes, Tommy's been working. He's got the intake manifold off, and I think he's ready to do this. Hey, Tommy, you ready to install this?
I am ready. If that thing's had enough camera time, can
yes.
The car have it?
Absolutely. At least we didn't have to lift it.
Are here from HRE. Alex went and picked them up this morning. Good news is, once these are painted, we put them on the car, we're ready to deliver the car.
And HRE sent them over already prepped.
Oh, dude. We won't say anything, but this is how it should be done.
Yeah.
Hey, Kenny, you're gonna be really happy right here. Huh? They're prepped. Since HRE prepped the wheels already, basically, all we got to do is mask them, put them in the booth, and spray them. We were going to do a white center, blue hoop, red stripe. The reason I wasn't going to do blue was because the stripe, the flag goes back into that rear wheel, and it's red. It would be red then. And you don't want to do that real wheel red and this wheel blue. That's going to look like...
Yeah.
So, yeah, we'll just do them white.
White center, blue?
White center, blue hoops, red stripe.
HRE really knew we were under the gun, so they prepped the wheels for us, so that really cuts it down. It'll save us about 4 hours of prep time today alone. So we can paint these wheels, get them on the car.
Coming up next on Inside West Coast Customs.
The wheels from HRE are painted, we wrap Continental tires on them, and this car is done and out of here.
All the final pieces are on for the next day or so, and this will be off to Detroit. So some of the points on this car are 22-inch HRE wheels, Continental tires, street scene body kit,
SLP performance. We're gonna upgrade the head unit to one of the new Pioneer touchscreen head units. From start to finish on this car, it's gonna have top of line everything. And really, that's the purpose of this. We wanna put the best of the best in the car, use my guys to perform what they do best, and raise some money for a great organization.
I just finished installing the Pioneer head unit, and one of the challenges with this vehicle is the radio. The factory radio is fairly large, like it's common in a lot of the newer vehicles. And the biggest challenge with this one is that it incorporates lock-unlock, your hazard switch, and all your heater and AC controls. So when you remove the factory radio, you're challenged quite a bit in what you put back in. But what we've got here is actually a kit that's specifically made for this vehicle. And you'll notice here that it's got all of the buttons to control everything that we replaced. And it's pretty cool that we can go from a boring, regular old CD player to now our Pioneer that's got the Pandora radio, it's got HD radio, it's got Bluetooth hands-free calling, navigation, I mean, everything that you could possibly want. It's a great unit. The replacement went great. It's gonna control everything, looks awesome, and it's gonna sound even better.
Yeah, now we got a box installed in there. We got the amps pretty much mocked up inside. Now just trying to make some beauty boards. I'm making a template one side right now. Once that's done, I'll be able to go ahead and cut the other side. And same thing for the bottom. And then once that's all done and said, we can give it to Ish, have him wrap it with the leather and make it look real pretty. Now we got the last woofer in there. It's time to go get the beauty boards that we made and put them in here and make it look beautiful.
Seats are done, time for me to put them on the car.
So what do you think?
Nice, perfect. I think the reflection is perfect. I hate to see all black back here.
Yeah, yeah.
Good job. Keep it in there, get it done.
We're done.
We had Oracle really put together something different. We wanted something blue, so we actually had them put blue LEDs everywhere.
Once I saw the Camaro put together, I figured, you know what, let's just paint the hood white because the American Cancer Society logo is just a little bit too much, and I really wanted the focus to be on that American flag. So now I'm gonna get the body shop on it, get it resprayed, and get this Camaro out the door.
The wheels from HRE are painted. Now we're just waiting for Mickey and Dee Dee to get here to put them together. And then we'll wrap Continental tires on them. Chris will pinstripe them. And this car is done and out of here. Okay, so here's all your parts and pieces. So you guys get to perform your magic wheel assembly task here.
Hey, everything looks great.
Yeah, it came out cool. It's a cool color.
Yeah.
I'll leave you guys to it.
All right, thank you.
Thanks, guys. Thank
you.
If you need anything, just give me a shout. I'll be in my office.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.
Oh, here we go.
Basically, we obviously build the wheels from scratch off of a raw forging. They're cut at our shop.
Typically, we do all the assembly once all the parts are manufactured in-house. With this special project, we're basically giving you guys the raw parts. We prepped them, you guys painted them. There's three pieces in a three-piece wheel. You have your inner barrel, your outer barrel, and your center. Inner barrel and outer barrel bolt together. The center is also in the center there, and then you bolt around the outside. We're really excited to be involved because it's a great car for a great cause. We just hope that our product helps make it look better and bring some more money at the auction.
So Camaro for a cause. We're close to being done. All the final pieces are on. Paint is done. Interior looks amazing. Supercharger's in. Wheels is the last piece we're waiting for right now. Hopefully in the next day or so, we'll get them on the car and this will be off to Detroit. Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs. So the car is finally done. I'm gonna take it over to the American Cancer Society office, get the final approval from Jill, and then ship it off to Detroit.
Project is nearly completed. The next step is get the front end on.
Great, banging, another banging system. Hell yeah. That's how we do it.
So now that we're done with this, it's time for the next project.
Painted. Next step, get Chris over here, do some of his pinstripe magic on it, put some Continental tires on them, and get this car on the road.
Well, I'm getting ready to put a red line around these wheels. Couldn't do it until after they were assembled. Right now I'm getting my paint palleted for it. It's got to be the perfect consistency to get all the way around without stopping. Get a nice clean line. And then they're going to stick them in the oven, bake them for a couple hours, throw some tires on them, put them on the car, and we're off to the show.
All done, all four of them are done. Ready to go in the oven, bake, get back on the car, and down the road.
Classic design concepts really came through with the last piece of the puzzle. This supplies a really nice roll bar. So once we get this roll bar on, this thing's off to Detroit. We got finished part.
So the car is finally done. I'm gonna take it over to the American Cancer Society office, get the final approval from Jill, and then ship it off to Detroit.
Ryan just called and he's on his way to our office here in Riverside, and I'm really excited to see the car with all the finishing touches. I think Ryan has the inspiration he needs to pull this car together. It is a high standard to meet. I'm pretty sure the crew at West Coast Customs has it covered.
What do you think?
I love it. when we were talking about the type of car, Ryan had said he chose a Camaro, and it seemed like such a good fit for this project because it sort of symbolizes the rebirth of America and the rebirth of Detroit. And then you tie in the American Cancer Society and our Road to Recovery program. It all just sort of came together.
I made a cool little plaque for it where I signed it.
Oh, nice.
So it's like a special, you know, it's like a one of one.
It's awesome.
Makes it unique.
It's cool. I can't get over it. I can't get over how it all came together.
I mean, it's got a ton of stuff. I think whoever's going to end up, you know, bidding on this car is going to see, like, we did big brakes on it. We did suspension. We did, you know, awesome
supercharged.
Yeah. So it's got power. It's got an awesome stereo system in it.
I love it. I think I'd look good in it.
I think so. I think so. It was nice.
I love the car. I do think the car represents the American Cancer Society really well. Getting a ride to cancer treatment can be the difference of surviving it or dying from it. Not only will it be an amazing fundraiser for the American Cancer Society, but it really is going to raise awareness about our Road to Recovery program. I think this car is going to do amazingly well at our auction. It's just a really cool car.
You gotta start it. Start it.
All right.
You gotta hear the motor in it.
Ready, guys?
It's got power. So we get your stamp of approval?
Absolutely.
Okay.
It's approved.
Good.
Thanks,
good.
Ryan.
Yeah, no, thank
Appreciate
you. It's good to see you.
It's good to see you,
Thank
too.
You very much for letting us do this build. I think, you know, this does mean a lot to us and my family, too. So this will be a good one. All right.
Thanks.
Then I'm going to take this.
All right.
And I'm going to get back to work.
Okay.
And I'll see you in Detroit.
All right. Thanks so much.
I just unveiled the car to Jill, and the good news is she gave us a stamp of approval. Whoever wins this car on the highest bid is gonna get an awesome car. I mean, it's got performance, it's got suspension, it's got awesome wheels and tires, it's got a great interior, it's got a great sound system, and it's a great car. Working with American Cancer Society really touches home for me just because we've recently had so much cancer in my family, and this one, I think, means a lot to us. We did a really good job. So now I gotta get this car back to the shop, get it loaded up, keep our fingers crossed, raise a lot of money for a great cause, and get on to the next build.
Folks, really and truly, this is an incredible vehicle right here. Tell me where, how much options on? Who gives $20,000? Let's go. I'm 20, here we get 25, 30, 35, 5,000, 75, 5, 75, here we get 75,000. I'm at 75, 80, here we get 85. 85,000, now $90,000, 90,000, back there we get 95, there we get 95,000, here now 100,000. I'm 100 here, and now 105. Sold it, 140,000.
I just really want to thank Ryan and the whole West Coast Customs crew for building this beautiful vehicle and raising awareness about the American Cancer Society and helping us raise more dollars to fund our mission to create a world with more birthdays.
Inside West Coast Customs. Just got a phone call from Lucas and they want to talk to me about doing a project. Since it is Lucas, I'm assuming it's Star Wars, so I'm really excited just since I am a huge Star Wars fan. This is really who we're talking about is Darth Vader.
You ready for this?
Yep, let's do it.
It may come in as a VW, but it's gonna leave Vader's ride. We're gonna build a car that Darth Vader would drive.